Denise. I'm one of the school nurses here at Hutto High School, and we are here today to demonstrate CPR. CPR is cardiopulmonary resuscitation, and this is to save someone, maybe a family member, best friend, grandparents. So we're going to get right to it. So when you go up to your patient or someone laying down, you're going to shake them, get their attention. Annie, are you okay? You're just looking to see if there's any kind of eye movement, moaning. Next, you're going to put your ear over their mouth, and this, you're trying to feel breath on your cheek, and you're also looking for chest rise, and you're only going to do it for 2 seconds. So quick, because we want to get right to those compressions to save a life. So once we've checked for breath sounds, no breath, we're going to start with compressions. So you're going to put the palm of your hand into the midline of the breast nipple line. So here's the nipple line. You're going to put the palm of your hand right below that, and then you're going to interlock your hands just like that. Make sure you're over your patient because you want to use your shoulders and your arms because you're going to get tired. You do not want to use your knees. You want to use your complete weight, so you're making sure you're going down and compressing hard on the heart. You want to go about 2 inches deep and about 100 beats per minute. So we're going to practice and go do 30. Here we go. 30 compressions, and then you're going to do 2 breaths. You're going to tilt back the head. You're going to put 2 fingers under the chin and use your other hand on top of the forehead. And what you're doing is just opening their airway. And you're going to give 2 breaths. Pinch their nose. These breaths are not hard. You're not wanting to rise their whole entire body. Of course, these are demonstration only, so it does just to show you how to do it. You want to blow easily and slow because you want to make sure you're getting that air in there. So 2 times. Once you give your 2 breaths, you're going to go right into compressions again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
You're going to do a complete 5 times with 2 breaths and 30 compressions to equal a whole set. And you will continue CPR until an ambulance, EMS, fire, or someone comes to relieve you. Because again, you can't save a patient, or a student, or a friend, family member, if you're passed out yourself because you're too tired. So when someone comes in, then let them continue. The American Heart Association has now agreed that you can actually just do compressions to save a life. So you don't have to do the breaths. So we're going to show you how to do just compressions with no breaths. Come up to your family member, patient. Annie, are you okay? No response. You're still going to look to see if they're breathing. Put your face over their mouth. You're looking for their chest to rise to see if they're breathing. No breathing. We're going to start CPR. Got to expose their chest. Remember, palm of your hand, midline of the nipples. Interlock your fingers. Pull your body in front and start with compressions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. And then for compressions, you just continue. You don't stop. There's no breaths. Complete compressions until someone can come and relieve you. You also can do this. If it's hard to remember how fast to do compressions, this is staying alive. fries. I'm going to get two breaths. Start compressions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
You're going to continue on doing your two breaths and then another 30 compressions. My AED is here. Once it gets arrived to your patient, continue compressions until these pads are attached. These AEDs are everywhere now. You can find them in airports, grocery stores, and they are monkey proof. They tell you everything to do. It talks the entire time. So just stay calm and just listen to what it says.
Stay calm. Follow these instructions. Make sure 911 is called now. Begin by exposing patient's bare chest. Remove or cut clothing if needed. When patient's chest is bare, remove the white square package from lid of AED. Tear open white package across dotted line and remove pads. Peel one of the white pads completely from blue plastic. Begin pulling from the tabbed cork. Firmly place the pad without the blue plastic on patient's bare chest, exactly as shown on pads. This pad can be placed on either of the two locations as shown on pads. Next, peel second white pad from the blue plastic. Firmly place the second pad on the other location exactly as shown on pads.
After the pads are attached, your machine is going to tell you when to shock. Your pads are going to pick up the cardiac rhythm of the patient's heart. Okay? It's going to tell you everything that you need to do. It's going to tell you when to push the button, and it's going to send a shock. Make sure you're not touching or even around your patient once this shocks you. If you're touching the patient, it's going to shock you. Just as a reminder,
the most important part of this is remembering the chain of command. Calling 911 early, early CPR, early AED, and emergency response. Those are the things that will save a life.
Now you go out and save a life.